species. In 1899, the U.S. Congress passed the Rivers and Harbors Act, which gave the Corps of Engineers the authorization to maintain the federal navigable waters of the United States, and that included the growing spread of invasive aquatic plants in the United States. Particularly here in Florida, that act gave us the ability to go into the St. John's River back in the as early as the 1880s to do some work in the St. John's River to reduce and to try to control the spread of back then what was a new plant to Florida, the water hyacinth.
Right. There's two questions that always come up when we talk about biocontrol. The first question is always, what else do they eat? And the second question, which is related to the first question, is what are they going to eat after they're done eating all the wheat? So the first question, most insects that feed on plants can only feed on a relatively few number of plants. Most of the plants that insects feed on are closely related to each other. And this is the cornerstone of wheat biocontrol. This is why it works. Megamelus feeds on water hyacinth, period. So the second question, we're never really talking about eradication. We're always talking about management. So the plants are never really eradicated. The plants' populations decline, and the insect populations decline with them.